Well, I think it was last Saturday. Tom Brown kind of reached out to Tug and Tug's manager, or Tug's like, you know, good buddy Danny, who kind of looks after him, and just told him like, look, Gamboa's out of the fight. You know, do you have any interest? It's in 2 weeks. You know, and then obviously, you know, I talked to Tom myself, and then I said, well, let me talk to Tug and I'll let you know, you know. Because Tug was supposed to fight, first he was supposed to fight May 29th, and then that kind of evaporated, opponent problem issues or whatever. And then we're on the schedule kind of like tentatively for the end of July. But Tug, so Tug been like training nonstop, like in training camp. He'd been actually living at my house since March 7th. So, you know, I've been watching every move he makes. So, I mean, the kid been working out, like he's been in the gym every day. So that's not like the major issue as he's been training. But I asked him, I was like, well, you know, what do you think of the fight? And I could tell by looking in his eye what he was gonna do. You know, obviously in my mind I'm weighing all the pros and cons to it, and but at the end of the day, it's like no risk, no reward at a certain point.
Well, I mean, he's good. That's the thing. He's an Olympic silver medalist. He's a talented fighter. And the sad thing is, because he's not a household name, that means most people are going to avoid him unless they're forced to fight him. So these are the situations that kind of you're kind of forced into as well.
At times, you know, sometimes, you know, things happen for a certain way for a reason, you know, like it just seemed like, again, we were having issues like getting his fight all together, like locked down. And it was supposed to be actually a really juicy, good fight, too. Similar to this fight, honestly, you know, the difficulty level of, I don't want to say who he's going to fight, who he was scheduled to fight, because they didn't, you know, they asked us not to say anything, obviously, when they were working through it. So I don't even want to say, but the difficulty level wasn't any harder or easy, you know. This fight's not like it's more difficult than that fight. It's just different. It's a different type of difficult, you know. One was a certain style and this is a certain style. So and like you said, at the end of the day, Tug's been fighting elite competition his whole life. You know, it's not that's not an issue. That's what he wants to do. He don't want to fight. Tug got 13 pro fights. He already fought for a world title. He fought a pound for pound type guy, future Hall of Famer for a world title, and lost a decision with, I don't know, 11 or 10 professional fights. I mean, he's not looking to fight lower competition.
And I've rewatched that fight last night because I'm a super boxing nerd. He was really in that fight. Like, it really just to me, the difference was Gary's experience as a pro. Like, that was the big difference.
Well, Gary knew what to do and when to do it. And Tug didn't train with me for that fight, so I can't comment as to how he was training, how he's preparing for the fight. But I don't think he was all the way. I don't think he was in top form for that fight. If
I'm picking up. I can interject there. I get what you're saying.
But it's not that, and I'm not. It's not me saying anything about it, Salas, because Salas is a fantastic trainer, and that's who he trained with, is Miles Salas, for that fight. I think the world is Miles Salas. I'm actually, you know, I think he's a great trainer. I just think I think a lot of that fell on Tug, you know, as far as what he thought he wanted to do. Well, he came back over here and he means business now, you know. He knows his clock is, he's 20, just turned 29 last week, so he's right here. This is the time to go, and he knows he got to be very, very serious and dedicated at this juncture. So here we are.
Well, boxing is a lot about relationships, and I think the fact that he's living with you and you're in the corner with him, that's a big deal. You know, that's a big deal going into this situation.
Yeah, that this is the first time, like I said, he's, you know, I trained him for quite a few fights in the past, but this is the first time that he's moved in, you know. I told him pretty much like, this is what we need to do, and he agreed. And you know, it's definitely different. Like you said, you know somebody, and you on a different level once you really live with
You know him too well. That's always what I
them.
say. You just know him too well. Like, you're like, oh, that's what you're doing.
Right. Yeah.
So a fan question, the Cobia Brita fight, what was the difference that we're going to see from that fight to this fight?
Again, I think you're going to see a totally different tug.